Blessing. Get on your feet. Welcome the amazing the Martins, Joyce, Judy, and Jonathan. I love you.
He leadeth me. Oh, blessed thought. Oh, words with heavenly comfort wrought. Whate'er I do, where'er I be, still 'tis God's hand that leadeth me.
Ashton, we're going old school for you today, girl.
There's not a friend like a lowly Jesus. No, not one. No, not one. None else could heal all our soul's diseases. No, not one. No, not one. 'Cause Jesus knows all about our struggles. He will guide till the day is done. There's not a friend like the lonely Jesus. No, not one. No.
Like the lowly
talk. Jonathan even asked me right before we walked up here, "You gonna say anything?" I said, "Probably not. I have to tell a story. I don't know if I've ever told you this. One of the last times that we visited here, we were sitting in this area here, and the praise and worship leader was going through all the praise and worship, and we were in the throes of some Holy Ghost worship time. Hi, Angie. Hey, Casey. I see you. And I was standing there, and he said, "The Lord wants you to give him some crazy praise." Now, I am an active worshiper. I raise my hands. I'll dance a little bit. I'll shout with the best of them. And he said, "The Holy Ghost wants you to give him some give the Lord some crazy praise." And the word popped into my head, "Run." And I went. I'd never run before in my life. Been in a lot of services where a lot of people ran. It always blessed me for other people to run. And I kind of ignored it and just kept going, worshiping the Lord, hoping he'd forget about me. But he said it again. "The Lord wants you to do something you've never done before and break free today and give the Lord some crazy praise." And the Lord said to me again, "Joyce, run." I started taking my shoes off, and my husband looked at me and said, "What are you doing?" I said, "I'm going to have to run." And I ran around this auditorium. I want you to know God set me free that morning. He did.
Praise Father, Son.
and